So ligaments, we have ligaments on the sides of our thumb and then of course on our IP. Now the IP of the thumb, the collateral ligaments there are very similar to the collateral ligaments here on the PIP, the fingers, right? So they're taut all the time and they're pretty hardy, right? They're pretty hardy. So if anything happens, just like you can test it by stabilizing this bone, the proximal bone, and then moving the distal end and seeing. So if I pull the IP more volar towards me, then I stress this side, the ulnar side of the IP. If I test it the other way, then I'll stress this one. But most of the time, that's not the one that gets injured. Most of the time, this one, the MP, is the one that gets injured, right? Because this one is a little bit different, right? It has extra ligaments that kind of hold it together. And majority of the time, it's gonna be your ulnar side, your inside thumb, that gets a lot of stress put into it. So when you pinch, you require those collateral ligaments to hold you together, right? To hold it so that this bone doesn't just shoot out of place, right? So your ulnar one, so with grip even, you'll see how much stress it puts there. So if you have someone with a collateral ligament issue at the MP, what's gonna happen? They're gonna complain about pain with pinch, with grip, and it's really specific. My pain hurts right here. They don't have stability when they do stuff. They just feel like it's just not right. Every time they do it, it hurts, like feels unstable, right? And it's usually with those things. Like, so if they ride or they do whatever, it's fine. But as soon as they have to do any heavy gripping, that's when it really stresses it. So if the ligament is over here and you're like, I don't know, is it torn? Is it irritated? Well, one, you can palpate it, right? And if there's point tenderness, right along that area, it might have some rupture, partial rupture. And the way you would test it is essentially you would hold the metacarpal and then you would laterally shift the P1 and it would put pressure here and immediately they would have pain. And you can go on the other side and test. So the collateral ligaments on the radial side, they're just stronger by nature. They're stronger, right? So, and most injuries don't push that way. I mean, every once in a while you might see that, might be in a car accident, might be whatever, but usually the ligament injury is they'll immobilize it for 6 weeks or so. Immobilize 6 weeks in a thumb spica. And this one is only in a hand-based. Right? Because it's just this, you're just controlling this joint. You don't have to stop the wrist from moving. There's nothing wrong with the wrist, right? So you would immobilize it here. And what happens is when they get immobilized, the whole point is to make it tight, to make it stiff. And then when they come out of the splint, you start gently moving, right? And usually what happens to indicate that it's more torn and it needs surgery is that as soon as you start getting the motion, the pain just kind of comes back. Can't pinch, can't grip, you know. And so usually that's an indication for surgery. So if they have a surgery, you have to go slow with them. But one way to continue to check is to check that pinch. You know, gently say, okay, you should see it gradually getting stronger and stronger. But if all of a sudden it was doing really well, but then all of a sudden it's like, now it hurts all the time, I can't progress, then that's one indication that maybe it's not as tight or secure as it or stable as it used to be, right? And then you gotta dive into some questions, say, you know, like tell me a little bit about what you did when the pain started, what were the tasks or the activities that you were doing? Because sometimes they don't think that they're doing anything wrong. I didn't do anything. And they're like, open a jar of, you know, salsa, you know, brand spanking new, and like, dude, that would put, I mean, talk about something and puts a lot of pressure on them. Like, but they think that they didn't do anything because nobody ever wants to feel like it's their fault, right? So you have to start looking from that perspective. Like if it's, you know, if it was doing really well, but all of a sudden it took a dive, they're not able to progress. That's another one. But then you can go back and check it and say, okay, does that feel like, you know, because how do you think the doctors test it when they're testing to see if their surgery is stable or not? Doing the same shit, right? They're doing the same thing, right? So that's gonna be ligament injuries.
Hey therapy friends, it's Huang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.